In pirate stories of old, finding buried treasure is always about a map where X marks the spot. In the deep water realm, however, things are rarely that simple. But could new underwater technology do away with treasure charts and help to locate what's possibly the greatest pirate haul in history?
Could the treasure have been right under our noses the whole time?
The mystery starts with an infamous Caribbean pirate called Captain Henry Morgan.
Captain Morgan is not just a rum bottle. He is actually a real person, and he's a real living legend in his own time.
Captain Morgan is no ordinary pirate.
Captain Morgan was a lieutenant governor in Jamaica and the surrounding area, and he was a privateer. Now, this is a form of pirate, but it's not a pirate as in Captain Jack Sparrow.
Privateers are pirates, effectively, who are appointed by a state.
So the 17th century is known as kind of this high age of piracy, the Pirates of the Caribbean, it always pops to mind. And a lot of the time, though, what people don't realize is that it was actually sanctioned by different crowns against warring factions. So you have people who are allowed under military law to go out and try to raid and attack ships of the opposing side.
Ultimately, he becomes a privateer because the English are at war with Spain. So he is authorized by the British government to wage war on the Spanish.
In 1671, Morgan sets out with 36 ships to raid the Spanish-controlled city of Panama and steal its gold.
Panama was one of the richest cities in South America at that time.
It was supposed to be lined with silver, gold, all sorts of things.
This was going to be his final raid, and it was kind of this go big or go home type moment.
It's the biggest heist of the age.
When Captain Morgan raided Panama City, he was successful. He managed to completely overwhelm the local authorities. He managed to achieve victory and get in and get what he was after, which was the gold and silver, and get out. He carried off 134 horse loads of gold and silver.
But then something unusual happens. According to one account, Morgan, unbeknownst to most of his men, sneaks back on board and leaves Panama with just three ships.
It is possible that he may have beat a hasty retreat because he had a ship full of treasure that he wanted to keep for himself.
When Morgan arrives back home in Port Royal, Jamaica, he has only one ship and a fraction of the loot. What happened to the rest of the treasure?
Did Captain Morgan make away with a lot of loot? And if he did, where did he stash it?
There were all sorts of rumors about where the treasure had been placed, what he'd done with it.
For over 300 years, people have put forward theories for the possible location of Morgan's missing treasure. But now a team of underwater archaeologists have discovered a shipwreck near Panama, and it's on the route Morgan would have sailed.
It was associated with Morgan's adventure because the material on the ship dated to that period.
Could this mystery shipwreck be the underwater hiding place for Captain Morgan's missing treasure?
They found cannons and chests, but after further analysis, they actually figured out that this was more likely a Spanish ship. So while these new ships and new evidence comes to light, really all it's doing is it's furthering the mystery.
So if the treasure's not on this shipwreck, where could it be? An interesting detail in accounts of the time could give us a new lead. Captain Morgan takes several weeks to get from Panama City back to Port Royal, much longer than expected.
Captain Morgan was a noted navigator. He was a very experienced merchantman in the area, as well as being lieutenant governor. He knew the area well. And yet, from Panama City back to Port Royal, he takes quite a long time to get there.
In 14 days, you could roughly do about 1,500, 1,600 miles.
Panama to Port Royal is about 600 miles. What can have taken him so long?
Could Morgan have stopped on his way back to Port Royal?
because he's a pirate, he doesn't have access to normal ports, so he would have to be very careful where he's going to make his stops.
There is one possible location.
On the route back from Panama City to Port Royal, you have this island called San Andreas.
San Andreas is a small coral island in the middle of the Caribbean Sea, reputed to be a favorite of Morgan's.
So on his way back to Port Royal, it's thought that Captain Morgan might have stopped off at an island called San Andreas, and it's speculated that he might have unloaded some of his cargo and spoils there.
Could they have stopped at San Andreas Island? Given the wind conditions, it would have been sort of on the way home if they were tacking to the north before tacking to the east to get back to Jamaica. And given the strength of the winds, they may have had time to stop and unload a ship.
He could have buried some of the loot on San Andreas, but that is a lot of loot to bury on one small island.
San Andreas is strewn with sea caves, making it an ideal place to hide treasure.
There are all sorts of rumors that he managed to find a very deep cave and stored all the gold down in there. And that has been a site of many treasure hunts for many years ever since.
Despite many searches over the years, no sign of Morgan's missing treasure has ever been found. Perhaps the solution lies closer to home.
Another theory that has always been present is that actually Captain Morgan kept the treasure with him, and it came back to Port Royal with him.
If you lived in Jamaica and you wanted to spend your money, you'd keep it somewhere nearby. You know, you don't want to have your closest ATM 1,000 miles away. It just doesn't make sense.
Port Royal was really the pirate haven of the Caribbean. And really, it's the setting for the modern-day view we have of what pirate life was like.
Morgan lived out the rest of his days in Port Royal, where he was buried, taking the secret of the missing treasure to his grave. Then, 4 years later, a natural disaster engulfed the city.
It actually sunk into the sea after an earthquake and a tsunami hit the region.
Did Morgan's treasure end up under the sea?
The potential could be that Morgan hid it somewhere around the city, and once that disappeared beneath the waves, so too did the treasure.
Now a team of marine archaeologists has begun to map the underwater remains of the sunken city.
It's there, more or less intact as an archaeological site to be investigated properly.
Perhaps this new research will finally locate Captain Morgan's hidden treasure. One of the techniques being used is photogrammetry.
Photogrammetry is a survey technique, a remote sensing technique.
You go and take photos of an area or an object, and you kind of go around it, and it's an algorithm, essentially, that meshes all these photos together and creates a 3D object.
It's only recently been developed to map underwater sites. The team can create a 3D picture of what the city looked like when it disappeared under the waves 3 centuries ago.
It lets you, you know, reach out and touch history. It's pretty cool.
If we can accurately create a map of Captain Morgan's period, then that gives us an idea of where such treasures might have been hidden.
It's early days, but when the map is finished, it should be possible to pinpoint where Morgan lived. Could the hiding place of his famous missing treasure be uncovered at last in the underwater ruins of Port Royal?
This isn't like finding a pirate ship, it's finding a whole pirate city. So who knows what you can find.